my name is Shivang Agarwal, and I'm a postdoctoral fellow in the AQ Chem Sim team at SandboxAQ. So I first knew that I wanted to get involved in AI and quantum tech in the early years of my PhD, actually. I was working on sort of classical chemistry, classical molecular dynamics stuff, and then I realized that going ahead quantum is actually the way. Before Sandbox, I was actually working on these quantum chemistry problems. And we ran into a lot of issues with computational compute because these calculations are extremely expensive. And then I heard about SandboxAQ and many others in this field trying to combine AI and quantum together to make things faster. That's when the light bulb went off that, you know, we need to really combine AI and quantum together. And so that was my green flag. Over time, my career has evolved quite a bit. My training as an undergrad was actually in electrical engineering, which is nothing at all what I do today. So I got a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering, thought I would change the world with transistors and stuff, but then I ended up pursuing a PhD in material science, where I eventually started doing quantum chemistry calculation, computational materials, and then I thought I would be doing more of these kind of stuff in my job. But then now, eventually at Sandbox, I'm actually combining both AI and quantum with the help of machine learning to do something that's slightly related, but also very different than especially what I initially started out as an electrical engineer. So it's been a long way. There were a few times where I had to adapt to major changes in my career, one of them being the transition from an electrical engineer to a material science engineer. It wasn't as difficult as I thought it would be, mostly because I was passionate about material science, so that helped a lot. I always had that fire within me to actually learn more, to implement more, to ask questions with my PI, and of course, a helpful PI definitely helped. It wasn't as difficult as I thought it would be. There was a lack of base knowledge, which I understand would be the case for a lot of people who are changing midway. But it's not the end of the world. I have experienced imposter syndrome once in my life. That was during a peak of COVID. I really didn't think I was doing anything of value. There were so many other people doing so many amazing things. What was I doing? Classic imposter syndrome. So it was a really difficult time, but what really got me out of it was talking to people really, really helped. I would not have been able to be where I am today without talking to a close set of people that I had in my life, luckily at that point. They gave me a lot of confidence that I am, you know, that I am worth it. And then once I had that a little bit of self-confidence, I didn't need too much, but as soon as you have a little bit of self-confidence, I was able to sort of plow on slowly and steadily, just start keep increasing my confidence. And to be honest, as soon as the lockdowns were lifted, that actually like really helped. So that was my journey through it. So the product that I'm most interested for SandboxAQ is actually the AQ NAV product. Because I think it comes at a really important time where the world is in a state of a lot of political unrest. And you know, GPS usage is not guaranteed for everyone. And so AQ NAV is a step above that. It's unjammable. It will have a lot of influence on a lot of people, and not just as a replacement for GPS where it's not available, but even for accuracy better than GPS. You can use it underwater. So I really think it has a lot of influence. You can check out SandboxAQ's YouTube channel for more videos on AI and quantum.